Fellers, be seated. Thank you, Marge.
And now, we will be joined once again by the Putnam County Middle School Drama Club, who will join Mr. Pant in the reviewing of our official spelling bee rules.
A speller.
A speller.
May ask questions. About the word's pronunciation definition.
Definition.
Use in a sentence.
In a sentence.
Or the language of origin. If you start to spell a word, you may start over, but the sequences of letters already spoken may not be changed. Largely aquatic, 4.5-foot-long rodent swimming next to you might be a capybara.
Wow. That didn't help at all.
Are you ready to spell the word, Miss Coney Bear?
No. But it was fun to come here. Hi, guys! My whole family's here, which is really C-A-P-Y-B-A-R-A. Happy Bora?
That is correct.
It is? I can't believe it!
Miss Ostrovsky.
I just did the first letters that came to my head, and the Y was just really... Miss Ostrovsky came in second in her school's Halloween costume contest.
I was roadkill.
Boanthropy.
Boanthropy, may I have a definition?
The delusion that one has become an ox.
Oh, could you not sit in that seat? I save a chair for my dad in the last row on the aisle. And it may take him a while, but when he gets here, that's his chair. 'Cause my mother's in an ashram in India. I saved a chair for a two, but it's merely symbolic, as daily she cleanses herself in the Ganges. Live in a house where there's an oversized dictionary that I read as a girl on the toilet.
Boanthropy?
Is that from the Latin root bo meaning ox and the Greek root anthro meaning man?
Sure.
I love my dictionary and I love the indented border. Every word's in down in the oral tradition. There's only one written citation of the word.
Can I please have flugeloom in a sentence?
Come hither, Heidi, and flugeloom!
Flugeloom. F L E U G A L O O M. Flugeloom.
That is correct.
Remarkable.
Angela Scrow.
on the 6th grade science fair for her project, Do Crayons Taste Like Their Names?
They do.
They do?
Your word is domain.
Okay, can I have the definition, please?
Yes. Any class of foul-smelling substances produced by bacteria during putrefaction of animal or plant protein.
A sentence, please?
Tomaine. Whoever spelt it, dealt it. Tim. Guilty. Tomaine.
T-O-M-A-I-N-E.
That is incorrect. The correct spelling is P-T-O-M-A-I-N-E.
Yes, of course. Lugubrious. Meaning extremely sad and or droopy.
More or less, yes.
A topic I'm all too familiar with. One moment, please.
Okay, watch this technique. He calls it the magic foot, and he's the only one I've ever seen use it. He spells the word out on the floor in order to get a visual before he speaks it out loud. Incredible!
Lugubrious. L-U-G-U. B-R-I-O-U-S. Lugubrious.
That is correct.
I know.
Mr. Nicholas Johnson?
Mr. Johnson has a birthmark shaped like the Philippines.
Your word is thalposis.
May I hear the definition, please?
Yes, a sensation of warmth.
Can you use it in the sentence?
Yes. After feeling another wave of thalposis, Tommy realized that he was in the kiddie pool.
T-H-A-L-G-O-S-U-S.
That is correct. Miss Park.
Miss Marcy Park is new to our county, having placed 9th in nationals last year as a representative of Virginia.
I've never been
beautiful
that far
country.
In
country.
Miss Park, the word is phylactery.
Phylactery. Am I pronouncing that correctly?
Yes.
Thank you. May I have the definition, please?
Either of two small square leather boxes containing religious texts. Traditionally worn on the left arm and head by Jewish men during morning weekday prayers.
Thank you. May I have a sentence, please?
Billy, put down that phylactery. We're Episcopalian.
Phylactery. P-H-Y-L-A-C-T-E-R-Y. Phylactery.
That is correct. Mr. Tolentino.
Slam dunk from Park.
Hey, Marcy, remember me from Nationals last year?
I only remembered the top 10.
Charlito Chip Tolentino is a little league pitcher with a wicked 22-mile-per-hour screwball.
Umphaloskepsis.
Wait, didn't the guy with the Philippines birthmark just get thalposis?
Yes, and you got umphaloskepsis.
And those are rated at the same level of difficulty.
They're both level 1 words, yes.
Umphaloskepsis.
Yes.
Can that also be pronounced omphiloskepsis?
It can. It would be wrong.
Omphiloskepsis. O-M-P-H-A-L-O-S-K-E-P-S-I-S. Omphiloskepsis.
That is correct.
He rallies and nails it. That's what it means to be a champion.
Mr. Isaiah Taylor?
Mr. Isaiah Taylor aspires to be as cool as Joey Sudo when he grows up.
I want to be as pretty, too.
Your word is cow.
What?
What? I can't hear you! I can finally speak cow.
Can you use it in a sentence, please?
Would you like the definition first?
Of course.
It's a cow.
Can I have that definition?
That's the definition? Oh. You use sentence?
Sentence, yes, please.
Please spell cow.
Segway.
Segway. F-E-G-U-E. Segway.
That is correct.
Siphon.
F-I-P-H-O-N. Siphon.
That is correct.
Cystitis.
The siphon. F.
No. Think.
C-I.
No. Logan, are you concentrating?
Yes.
Maybe it's time for rank.
Dana, we're in the middle of a word here.
You know she doesn't spell well when her blood sugar is low, Carl.
We need to build up her stamina. This beat could last 3 hours.
Don't you talk to me about stamina. Who solved the 24 by 24 Rubik's Cube behind their back while blindfolded yesterday?
I'm sorry.
Okay, well, last time I checked.
I'm rocket science.
Gator conference, now!
No! Gator! Let me get this one first!
We need a spelling, Logan. That is correct. Miss Coney Bear.
Miss Coney Bear makes her own clothes.
A coochie.
A what?
Listen to the whole word, please. A coochie.
What does that mean?
A South American rodent of the genus Myoprocta, resembling an agouti.
It's funny how I keep getting South American rodents.
Hilarious.
Look, honestly, I've never heard this word before. I have no idea how to spell it.
Would you like to forfeit your turn?
Why don't you give it your best shot, Miss Coney Bear?
I'm not that smart. My siblings have been telling me that for years. That I'm not smart. We're schooled at home. They see who's bright. It breaks my heart. I'm not that smart.
Guess what? You know what? Guess what?
Egrotet. Yes.
Can I have the definition, please?
Yes.
Yes, a medical certificate stating that a student is ill.
Can I please have that in a sentence?
Yes. Frankie, I'm not saying that you weren't sick, but this Egro tat is written on an Arby's napkin.
Egro tat. E-G-R-O-T-E... T... Egro tat.
That is incorrect. The correct spelling is A-E-G-R-O-T-A-T. That's correct.
My old friend. One moment, please.
He's going for the foot!
Magic foot, take me to the final round. Magic foot, barely lifted off the ground. Magic foot, do it without making a sound. to spell. All right, well, let's see what we got this time.
Balmaken.
Can I hear the definition, please?
Yes. The definition is unknown, but it is known that it is an old cowboy term, circa 1860, passed down in the oral tradition. There are two written citations.
May I hear it in a sentence, please?
Yes. Get along, little doggy, and balmaken! Yeehaw! That is incorrect. The correct spelling is B-A-L-M-A-C-A-N. Balmaken.
Q-A-M-A-M.
is remarkable.
It's correct. Miss Park is all business.
No, I'm not.
Mr. Tolentino.
Marigold. Marigold Coney Bear. That's a lovely sweater, Marigold.
Chip?
Oh, sorry, is it my turn to spell?
A rare brain concentration from Mr. Tolentino.
She's even cuter up close. Hey, that girl over there ain't bad either.
Chip, hey, thank you. Can you maybe skip me now and ask me two in a row later?
You can either take your turn right now or forfeit.
I'll take my turn right now.
Another excellent decision by the incumbent.
Sit up.
What?
Your word is sit up.
Definition, please.
Lively movement or behavior. To move restlessly. It refers to the sound of horses' hooves. Sit up. Sit up. Sit up.
Sue Sanders ain't bad. Infernal old lady.
Mr. Tolentino! T-I-T-U, wait, two T's, you heard them both, right? Backing up, T-I-T-T-U-P.
That is incorrect. The correct spelling is T-I-T-T-U-P.
But that's exactly what I said.
No, you said T-I-T-U, oh wait, backing up, there's two T's, T-I-T-T-U-P.
But I wasn't sure if you heard both T's or not all the words.
Start over, about the sequences of letters already, smoking pain, melting chain.
Nothing you can do to comfort these kids. They don't yet know that the good don't always win. So there's nothing you can do to cheer them up when they lose. I want to tell them that disappointment doesn't last, but from what I have seen, disappointment lasts like hell. I want to tell them that words don't matter. But from what I've seen, words can get you killed. I want to beat them up a little bit, you know? So they know that pain has degrees and that this is nothing. This is nothing, you little freaks. But that would violate my parole. So I do what I can. I give him a juice box and a hug. I'm only here to give comfort. Let's go, kid.
Miss Pretty, can I have another chance? Please.
Let's go, kid.
Future Gym Teachers of America.
Your word is abulia.
Abulia, of course. Is that the definition?
Yes, a mental illness characterized by the inability to make decisions.
Can you use it in a sentence, please?
On their day off from the hospital, the abulia patients spent the whole day in the parking lot saying, I don't know, what do you want to do?
I don't know, what do you want to do?
I don't know, what do you?
Oh. Abulia.
Abulia. A-B-O-U-L-I-A. Abulia.
That is correct.
Very good.
Isaiah Taylor.
Mr. Taylor was just here.
Your word is lysergic acid diethylamide.
It's like four words.
One big word.
Could you repeat the word?
Yes. Lysergic acid diethylamide.
Lysergic acid diethylamide.
Yes.
Could you define that for me, please?
Yes, I will. A hallucinogenic drug that produces profound changes in perception and mood.
Could you use that in a sentence?
Yes. The researcher experimented with way too much lysergic acid diethylamide and thought she was a glass of orange juice.
Lysergic acid diethylamide. L-I-C-E-R-G-I-C.
That's incorrect. The correct spelling is L-Y-S-E-R-G-I-C-A-C-I-D-D-I-T. That's a long word.
My friend, you will be missed. But now go with dignity. This ends but first on our list. You can go with Spell with pain.
boat roll.
Chips, pretzels, all for $1. Can you believe they did this to me? It's so humiliating. Hey, you know what? Free candy for everyone! Free chips for you. M&M's for you. Trolleys, it is tradition that the person eliminated from the competition is fair game for derision. Especially the alpha male, who goes so goodies at the bake sale. Anyone for brownies, anyone for chocolate chips, anyone for anything that isn't dated. How could I have been eliminated? You wanna know how? You wanna know how? You wanna know why? My unfortunate distraction has destroyed all interaction. Once to my satisfaction, that everything I did perfectly. Last year's chip defeated early because of variable pony bear, who causes this weird and wonderful sensation. I now have excitement but lack concentration. My unfortunate unfocus, blame it on love's hocus pocus. Anyone for M&M's? Delicious and appropriate. Anyone for chewy goobers? Expensive. Anyone for buying this goop that I'm selling? Because my puberty's ruined my spelling. Distraction! Distraction! My unfortunate distraction! Whoa! It's ruining my life, it's ruining
I know your name. I do not need pity from a person named after a vegetable.
Well, it's a fruit.
Well, it's a disgusting fruit. I can't keep them down. I guess it's okay for a name, though.
Did you know that if you switch the first two vowels in olive, it becomes I love?
Did you know if you switch the first two vowels in William, it becomes William?
Yeah, but if you switch the next two, then it's Will-A.
Are these really the kinds of things you think about?
Yeah.
All right, then. I'm more of a science guy myself.
Well, you're also a really great speller.
Yeah? Well, thanks. Olive. I love. That's so stupid.
Because losers do not know how to win.
spell indicate?
Indicate. I-N-D-I-C-A-N-T, indicate.
Correct.
Miss Teddy Bear? Please spell Fulpine.
Fulpine. B-U-L-P-I-N-E, Fulpine.
Correct.
Miss Ostrovsky? Halleck.
Halleck. H-A-L-L-U-X, Halleck.
Correct. Mr. Barfield.
It's Barfetti.
Please spell Caliber.
Yes, of course. One moment. P-A-L-A-B-E-R, Caliber.
That's correct.
I know.
Ms. Park? Roybos.
R-O-O-I-B-O-S, Roybos.
Correct.
Ms. Horsigates. Tilapia.
Tilapia. T-I-L-A-P-I-A, Tilapia.
Ms. Cody Bear?
Sheila thinks that my hobbies are weird, but my real mom, Joan, says that one day the science will pay off. And also, I will grow up to be incredibly handsome.
Antihistamine.
Woo! Luck of the draw. One moment, please. A-N-T-I-H-I-S-T-A-M-I-N-E. Antihistamine, Mr. Penchy?
Doug? Hedge.
Will Barfay.
Miss Park.
Miss Park speaks five languages.
No, I don't.
Don't you?
No.
Well, it also says you won your school's handwriting competition.
Does it also say that I only sleep 3 hours a night, and that I hide in my bathroom cabinet, and that I'm not allowed to cry?
No, it doesn't say that.
Well, it should. And it should say,
My apologies. Sluice.
Sluice. May I please have the definition of that word?
Yes. It's an artificial passage for water with a valve or gate for stopping and regulating flow.
And are there any alternate definitions?
Yes. A channel to drain or carry off surplus water.
And are there any alternate definitions?
Yes. A body of water pent up behind a floodgate.
And are there any alternate definitions?
Why don't you just quit stalling and spell the stupid word?
Principal Pants!
Vice Principal Pants! Vice Principal! They won't let me be principal!
Huh. I wonder why.
Oh, that's no good. No, let it dry. We have to disable the foot.
What foot?
The magic foot.
Wouldn't that be wrong?
Do you want to win?
Yes, but I believe in ethical conduct.
And isn't having a magic foot an unfair advantage?
I don't have a magic foot.
Or a mother.
Can we have all parents in their seats, please? This is not a soccer game.
You're lucky your parents are in India.
No, only my mom is. My dad's gonna come from work.
I apologize for that incident. In my defense, I would like to point out that I am lactose intolerant.
Really?
Are you even lactose intolerant?
Yes, Sue. Miss Ostrovsky.
What did my dad say?
Your dad said he's running late and he'll discuss the entrance fee with you when you get home.
But did he say what time he was going to get here?
Chimerical.
What was the word?
Chimerical.
Can I have the definition?
It means unreal, imaginary, visionary, wildly fanciful, highly unrealistic.
I go.
Mr. Barfy. Crepuscule.
I'm sorry, crep?
Crepuscule.
Ah, yes, of course, crepuscule. One moment, please. C-R-E-P. Crep. U-S. Ew! There's something sticky on the floor. I'll take it from the crep. U-S.
We need a spelling now.
Can I just wipe my foot off first?
Now, William.
Can I get a definition?
It means twilight.
Can you use it in a sentence?
She thought she was walking into the dawn, but it turned out it was the crepuscule.
Ew. Crepuscule. C-R-E-P. U.S. C-U-L-E, crepuscule.
That is correct, Mr. Schwarzengate.
Mom! Mom! I did it without the foot!
I'd just like to say that I can do this on my own!
Vug.
Vug? That's the whole word, vug?
Vug.
Language of origin?
Cornish dialect, a Latin derivative.
Cornish. That's like English, but with Dutch influence. Vug. V-U-G-G-H-E. Vug.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is V-U-G, vug.
So simple.
So simple.
I'm so sorry, Gator. I overcomplicated. I hope you still love me, America, America. I gave it my best try. If you still don't love me, America, I understand why you hate losers. So do I. I'm a
I feel joy, but I also feel pain, because I know
Mr. Barfi, Coryza.
Coryza.
Ilspile.
Ilspile?
Zoonosis.
Zoonosis, yes, of course. And does that happen to be the same word that can be flipped upside down and still spell the same word?
Fabache.
Fabache, and does that happen to be the longest word that can be played on a musical instrument?
Chromatophore.
Chromatophore. And if you were to rearrange the letters in that word, you could form the phrase, Mr. Pooh ate my rock.
Or Chief Pooh Mister.
Hop home carrots.
Rap home corn.
Mr. Barfi, please spell astral bleed.
Sir!
UNG, Belton Shower.
We have a winner!
So hard for this moment. Most of my life, I could only breathe out of one nostril. And today is no exception.
And this year, there's also a runner-up prize.
There is?
Yes. As all of you know, if for any reason our champion, Mr. Barfay here, cannot fulfill his spelling duties, our runner-up must step in and take his place. So this year, our sponsors are offering up a $25 runner-up prize. Nice going, Mrs. Strofsky.
Thank you. I can't believe it. Thank you. Miss Pretty, I can pay the fee now.
Very good. Very good.
Very good.
Could be.
What are you too, Ostrowski?
I made a dumb mistake on healing lessons.
No, you didn't. I didn't know how to spell that one either.
Right.
Yeah, you're right. I totally knew how to spell that.
Hey, Barf.
Yeah?
Congratulations.
Aww.
Oh, shut up!
After the beat, Douglas Panch found a new passion in life. Her name was Rona Lisa Peretti. After courting her tirelessly for over 2 years, she filed a restraining order against him. Although he was grateful for the opportunity to experience love.
Rona Lisa Peretti left Putnam County for a stretch and traveled the world to bring competitive spelling to the less fortunate. She hosted national bees in the countries of Latvia, Sweden, and the nation of Guinea Bissau, where she fell in love with an indigenous cashew farmer and became one of the top realtors in that country.
Sue Sanders used her love and passion for language to become the best news anchor the Channel 4 has ever seen. After 4 failed engagement attempts, Sue sold the rings and became a sponsor of Future Bees. She donated $25.
Marge Mahoney discovered a new passion at the Bee and decided to make her community service lifelong, comforting eliminated spellers and frustrated educators across the nation. Over the years, she kept in touch with many she had comforted.
Dear Marge, I've got a restraining order.
Chip Tolentino made it through adolescence and in the course of time came to appreciate his distractions, as did many others.
Which many